Okay, so let's look at 11.6, rotational inertia, which we're familiar with, but now not of a particle, but of an extended object. Okay, so what do I mean by that? Well, we know that most of the examples we've looked at like a puck, for example. And a puck is basically a particle, which means that effectively we don't consider its size. All mass is concentrated into a single point. Okay, it's got no size. It can't deform. It's got no internal structure. Okay, and then what we did was it was connected to a cable or to a negligible rod, and it rotated about some point. Okay, which is called the axis of rotation. And so, for example, if we said, what is the rotational kinetic energy of this particle? It was half I omega squared. Remember, the linear translational kinetic energy is half mv squared. And so this is the rotational equivalent. But then your rotational inertia was given by m r squared, your rotational inertia, which is simply the inertia of this particle times the perpendicular distance. So we drew a perpendicular, if this particle was moving in that direction, then we drew a perpendicular distance from the line. This is called the line of action. And a perpendicular distance, and that was your r. So your rotational inertia was mr squared. But this is for a particle. Okay, let me go back actually to the textbook. Let's go back here, and we can see this guy here. I equals mr squared was for a particle. Okay? But now, let me just come back here. Now, what we want to do is, we want to look at the rotational inertia, not for a particle, not for something where all the inertia is concentrated into one single point. We want to calculate the rotational kinetic energy, for example, but we need this guy. We need the rotational inertia, but not for this, but for an extended object. For a cricket bat, right? For an object that looks like this, you know, and then like a 10 pin bowling, okay? Or a tennis racket, or a cylinder. These are extended objects. That means all the mass is not concentrated into one, it's not a particle. There's a distribution of mass all over, okay? There's a distribution of mass. The mass is distributed all over. So we need to find a new way to find I. So remember, if in the cricket bat, if that is our point of rotation, then we need to find a way to determine the rotational inertia for all the mass. Okay? If that is our point of rotation on the 10-pin bowling thing, the pin, then we need to find a way to determine the rotational inertia for all the mass about that point. Okay? So I think that's good. I'll stop there. We'll carry on in the next one.